If we speak about regional issues and regional policy, then it would be probably very important to say about Ukraine's relations with Russia. They are not the best. They are not like making you proud of, because I'm sure that neighbors need to have better relations and should be able to solve even inherited challenges. But with that, I'd like to say that we have a very clear agenda of our relations with Russia. Obviously, there will be time when Russians will find guts and wisdom and possibilities to welcome such relations. Obviously, we have the whole range of challenges we have to solve, and we would be willing to do that. But not everything is now within Ukraine's will. What's the most sensitive for our relations? I would mention probably 3-4 issues, so it would not be the complete list. I'd start with the border issue. This year, Ukraine celebrated the 18th anniversary of its independence, but unfortunately, the entire surface border between Ukraine and Russia is not demarked. We don't have any single foot of our border where we would have legitimate and approved line of borderline. And it's not a political issue that stand on the way to take the problem off. We don't have these problems on the surface border. We had 27 rounds of negotiations about that. And we finalized them and have taken away all the problems about the surface border. And we believe that the both sides, from the technical standpoint, are for a long time ready to sign the respective agreement and demark the border. They should clearly state where the land of one country ends and where the rules of one constitution ends and where a different one starts. Unfortunately, that work is not being done, and this is not our fault. However, I always put those things into our agenda, and I recently sent a letter to the Russian president with a proposal to come back to that issue again. The situation is quite complicated on delimitation of frontiers, of water frontiers, and especially such sensitive points like Tuzla Island, where the territory that belongs to, and from the administrative standpoint, belongs to Ukraine, and on all the administrative maps of the Soviet Union, it always belonged to Ukraine. And obviously, we will never approach this issue with any other conditions, because Tuzla Island would always remain Ukrainian. But unfortunately, Russians have different thoughts about that, which are not acceptable for us whatsoever. They are not and will not be acceptable. Another serious problem is the presence of the Russian Black Sea Navy deployed in the Crimean Peninsula. The Ukraine's position is clear and transparent. The agreement that was signed in 1997 foresaw 20 years of Russian Black Sea Navy deployment until May 27th, 2017. But the Ukrainian side believes that the Ukrainian constitution prohibits any military bases deployed in the Ukrainian territory. I mean, military bases of foreign states. This is an imperative and direct norm of the Constitution. Obviously, the issue of our integration to NATO adds more complicated things into the Ukrainian-Russian relations. And here I would like to give you several pieces of information as an official Ukrainian position. First of all, when we speak about our NATO integration, it's not about how to form new threats or challenges for any other third party. However, that matter is very often speculated in the Russian press. This is not our target to make it harder for something, but this is the target of giving the answer to this sufficient national security policy. Just a little bit of a history. Just in the last 70 years, since 1917, we declared our independence 6 times, and 5 times we lost it. And there was only one reason behind: the international factor. And that's why we need to take out lessons. The only way to, and not only for Ukraine, on the European continent, to have the most perfect security and defense policy is to have the status of pan-European collective security. There is no other answer to this. We don't want to lose our independence like we did many times in the 20th century. That's why NATO membership and the Ukrainian independence, I'd say, are synonymous. That's why we speak about our natural aspiration. When we are told that Ukraine will enter NATO and we're going to have a NATO base in Sevastopol, we say no. Our constitution gives a guarantee that no foreign military base, neither Russian or no other country. This is the imperative norm of our constitution. We are often reproached that they can install some nuclear deposits and nuclear weapons over there.
Mr. President, what's your assessment of the Obama administration canceling plans for the European missile shield? And what impact do you think that'll have in your relationships with Russia?
Well, I promised not to be telling anything wrong about neighbors and friends. Well, I'll try to give a delicate answer to your question. Obviously, what is to be deployed in the Polish and Czech territory is the competence of the people of Czech Republic and Poland. Apparently, if the interests coincide with the American administration, then it would be really good. If we speak about any defense initiative, including when we speak about the European continent and how to strengthen it, how to make it more efficient. In other words, when we speak about a defense component of the international policy, in my opinion, this is always good. This is my personal conviction. To make defense stronger and make it more efficient is always good. And this gives more benefits than the policy of risk balances, because the risk management and the risk balancement is the policy of not is not a stable policy. But when we try to ensure the concept of pan-European and Euro-Atlantic security in this very situation, including the American component, I think that this should be perceived correctly by the parties that are involved, or the parties that have to do or have to deal with the answer to this. Because once again, to be more precise, I think we have to be more about the initiatives to strengthen our defense, and this is probably the way of developing the situation, whether we speak about European or non-European territory. At the end of the day, this is the right of any nation to have the most sufficient defense doctrine. That's why strengthening the defense component, I think, has to be welcomed and developed. If you could understand my answer, I would be very grateful.